My house has one of those fireplace models. It is powered by natural gas and it's completely sealed. That makes it safer because it exhausts to the outside and eliminates any exposure to carbon monoxide, so only the heat makes its way through the glass. But there is a downside to this. It is completely silent. I mean, boringly silent. And it doesn't produce that warm feeling when you hear the wood log popping and crackling. So in this project, I will make my fireplace a little more authentic. In a previous video, I had this project where I was able to play any audio using a MrDIY Mini from a URL. And since I just need to play one audio file in this project, I decided to have everything local and skip the Wi-Fi component. The plan is to create a device that plays an MP3 of popping and crackling sounds when the fireplace starts. Something like this. That's the general idea. But I also needed some specific features to make it just right. First, I noticed that it takes roughly 30 seconds for the gas to flow and the pilot to trigger when I start the fireplace. This means I need to have a delay before the audio starts playing. Second, I need to find some power source that's only hot, or should I say active, when the fireplace is on. No pun intended. Third, I need a speaker that will fit in the fireplace cavity but will also be heard from across the room. So given those restrictions, I came up with this design. It uses four components: an MP3 decoder, an amplifier, a speaker, and a microcontroller. Here is the MP3 decoder. It's called DF Player Mini. It supports multiple sampling rates, can read files off an SD card in the FAT format, has adjustable audio levels, but its best feature is that it can be controlled over UART or serial. And it only costs $1. Luckily, I only needed the datasheet for the wiring diagram, as the software was already been taken care of by this library. The code for this project is very straightforward and was done on an Arduino Nano. In the code, I included the library and created a software serial to be used for the communication with the MP3 module. Then I started with a 30 seconds delay to give time for the fireplace to start, then issued a command to play all MP3 files on the SD card in a loop. I'm only planning to have one file on the SD card, so that soundtrack will continuously repeat or until the fireplace is turned off. The sound coming off the MP3 module is not that loud, that's why I needed to add an amplifier. This is a very low cost module, uses the PAM8403 chip. A shout out to PCBWay for being today's video sponsor. They provided me with the PCBs for this project. Personally, I really like PCBs. They make any project look polished and less prone to wiring and soldering disasters. I will link to their site in the description. So a week after I placed my order, I got my boards, added the components, and connected the speaker. This might look like a very small speaker, but trust me, it can get very loud with that amplifier. As for the power, luckily the fireplace controller has a 5 volts output that I was able to power the whole device from. And now I can sit back, relax, and enjoy my more authentic fireplace experience. Thank you for watching. Peace.